Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sagar Prajapati and in this video I will be solving another question of SQL, which is rising temperature. Okay, so before going into this problem, I would suggest you, if you haven't watched my series, then go and watch here. If you can see here, I have uploaded 4 videos till now, and so if you haven't watched, you can watch these 4 videos and then you can continue with the new one. Okay, so chalo, now we will see what is our problem statement. So problem statement is rising temperature. Okay, so here we have one table called weather, where we have ID, record date, temperature as columns, and then we need to write an SQL query to find all dates ID. Okay, ID with higher temperatures compared to its previous day. It means yesterday. Okay, and result, return the result table in any order. Okay, so for an example, if you can see here, we have this ID. We have this table called weather, and we have this ID, record date, temperature, and this is the data, right? So if you can see here, for this date, okay, for this date, temperature, yesterday temperature is what? 10, and today's temperature is 25, which is what? So the before temperature is less than the today's temperature. So I will not print ID 1. Now we will move on to ID 2. If I can see here. The higher temperature compared to previous day. Okay, sorry. So for if you compare ID 1 and 2, then 25 is the highest temperature as compared to the previous day. So I will print 2 ID. Now if I compare 2 and 3, then what will happen? We are seeing 25 and 20, right? Which is 25 is greater than 20. So I will not print this. If I compare 3 and 4, then you can see here 30 is greater than 20. So I will print here. So abhi aapko samajh mein nahi aaya. So for that, what I will do, I'll open an Excel, and let's say this is our ID and this is our date, and then this is the temperature, right? Now for an example, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And here temperature is 10, then 25, then 20, and this is 30. Or yahan pe date le lo. Today. Today minus 4. Okay. इसको कॉपी करेंगे माइनस 3, ठीक है, यहां पे हो जाएगा टुडे माइनस 2 और यहां पे हो जाएगा माइनस 1. Now this is our table. So I will create this table. Now what we want to do, we want to compare ये वाली continuous rows, consecutive rows जो हैं वो compare करनी है. Okay, one before after. So for that, what we can do, we can create one more copy of this table. Okay, now what we will do, we will compare this ID with this ID. I mean, basically from starting, what we do, this ID will, this row will compare with this row. If ID is matching, then we should not bother about it. We can skip this row. When ID is not matching, then what we will do? We will compare the dates, okay? And then we will compare the temperature. So here the temperature is 10 and here temperature is 20, which is wrong. Sorry, which is correct, right? Temperature 10, temperature, sorry. What is the problem statement? The problem statement is the temperature was higher than the previous, okay. So temperature is highest than the previous day, right? Then we will print ID 2 like that, okay. And then abhi kya hoga? 2 ka ho gaya, then we should not compare 3. We should not compare 4 as per the problem statement. Then the loop starts from ID 2 and it will go here. Okay, it will start from this 3 and it will check it whether, you know, this 25 is greater than or 20 or less than 20. Since here 20 is less than, then we should not print here 3. And if I compare this 3 and 4, then here 30. I mean, the current temperature is greater than the previous date temperature. So I will print here 4. Right, so let's see how we can write the SQL statement here. So I open my lead code, and what I do here, I will write select, okay, ID from weather table. I will use self join, okay? So W2 likh lo, where W1 का temperature is less than what? W2 का temperature. Right? And date diff is the predefined function. W1 dot record date comma W2 dot record date is equal to 1. So if I run this, sorry, it will fail now. I will print here W1. Date diff is not defined. I guess diff date function is there. Okay, let me check the function name. Date diff function in MS SQL. Year. Then this, okay. So if days you look on, right? So what I will do here, date diff, and then I can write here day. Now if I run this, अभी देखो हमारा आंसर क्या आया, 13. Why? Because I have written here W1, my bad. I should write here W2. So if I run it now, then it should print. अभी सही हो गया. If I do submit, then it should pass all the cases. अभी ये पास हो गया, ठीक है. तो आई होप आपको ये बेसिक समझ में आएगा. देखो मैंने यहाँ पे सेल्फ ज्वाइन यूज़ किया, आप यहाँ पे इनर ज्वाइन भी यूज़ कर सकते हैं, ठीक है. सो इफ़ आई राइट हेयर समथिंग लाइक दिस इनर ज्वाइन, ठीक है, एंड इफ आई डू ऑन दिस ऑन W1.id नॉट इक्वल टू W2.id and I will write here where condition, and then if I run this, it should print. सबमिट करेंगे तब भी रन होएगा। अब ये क्या होगा, लूप पूरा नहीं चलेगा, ठीक है? आई गेस फास्टर होना चाहिए, लेट्स सी। ओके, ये फास्टर तो नहीं हुआ, फास्टर तो पहला वाला ही सॉल्यूशन था। ओके, हो सकता है कुछ यहाँ पे गलती हो, बट आई होप आपको समझ में आ गया होगा कि यहाँ पे मैंने क्या किया है, राइट? मेरा करने का तरीका क्या था, यहाँ पे हम इनर ज्वाइन, यहाँ पे आई होप यू कैन यूज लीड और लैग फंक्शन ऑल्सो, आई एम नॉट श्योर, बट या वी कैन, आई होप सो। ठीक है, तो अगर वीडियो अच्छी लगी हो तो लाइक कर देना, दोस्तों के साथ शेयर कर देना। तब तक के लिए बाय एंड अ हैप्पी न्यू ईयर।